Okay, so the year is starting to wrap up here in 2019, and we're looking forward into self-publishing. I'm going to speculate 5 predictions about self-publishing 2020, and I'm going to give a little bit of evidence in the fact that we could be heading in this direction, these 5 different areas. You want to learn more about that? Make sure you stay tuned to today's podcast. Hey, this is episode 35 of Self-Publishing with Dale podcast. It's kind of crazy to think that I've been recording it this stinking long, and I'm so glad if you've joined me just now or you've been listening to me for a long time, whether you're listening to me in your car ride or you're listening to me during your workouts or while you're working, I do appreciate all the support. And speaking of support, today's podcast is sponsored by Vexels. It's just a big quick shout out to Vexels.com. Their graphic design platform I've been using the most of as of late, with over 100,000 graphics, illustrations, and designs that can be used on any kind of publication. That's any. Whether it's the cover, inside pages, or a full-fledged coloring book, in Vexels, you'll satisfy any designs you need you have. And to set up your account today, please visit dalelinks.com/vexels. Again, that's dalelinks.com/vexels. And of course, we're going to leave a link inside the show notes. That way, if you forget this, you can always go ahead and copy and paste that into your browser. Help support the podcast and also help support an awesome company in Vexels. So let's go ahead and jump right into things, because people want to know, like, hey, what kind of predictions do you have? Listen, I'm not right all the time, but there has been a fair amount of times that I predicted some things, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to point to the fences on some of these things. And some of them may not happen next year, and some of them may not happen at all, but I'm fairly confident these ones are probably going to come to fruition in the very near future. And I'm just going to go ahead, I'm going to go all in on these 5 predictions in 2020. Let's just go ahead. We're going to start it out as we think about wrapping up 2019. I want you to think about what we've accomplished this year. And by the way, we're going to probably do a year retrospective into next week's podcast recording. So just know that we'll review everything in 2019. But, you know, I want you to think back on what we've accomplished this year in self-publishing, what has happened, the people who've come and the people who've gone, and the people that continue to blaze the trail here in self-publishing. So here we go. Let's start it out with number one. And number one, this is going to be an interesting one. It's new information content providers. You're like, what do you mean? So there's a lot of people making a lot of noise in this space of self-publishing. And actually, some of them are making good noise. So you got the likes of people who've been around this space for a long time, like the Joanna Penns and the Mark Dawsons and the Brian Cohens. And, you know, they continue to stay in this business and they don't look like they're going anywhere. I feel pretty confident I'm not going anywhere anytime soon. But then there are some other ones that have come into the space, whether they've had the best of intentions or the worst of intentions. Either way, they are the information content providers, the ones that are giving us. And I'm going to tell you that I've seen a few YouTube video content providers kind of fade away over the last year. Some of them that were really big influencers in the space. And I see them contributing far less in the community. And I see them doing less in self-publishing, and it might be for good reason. Maybe they burned out. Maybe they just kind of got to the point where they said, well, this is not the business for me, and best of luck to them. I don't want to sit here and shame anybody if they want to go ahead and take their ball and go somewhere else, but there are some people that, honestly, they're gone. But there are people that are starting to come into the forefront, and I'm going to go ahead and just name drop just a couple of people, and you know, people that just jump off the top of my head. Now, I'm not saying they're going to blow up really big, but they're a great example of new content providers that are starting to step to the forefront. You got people like Jacob Rothenberg, and Jacob, you know, when he started out, I wasn't a big fan of his content, and I think I even expressed this to him, you know, straight up, because he just didn't have a good moral compass, in my opinion. Then I believe that he's actually cleaned up his act, and he's continuing to do that, and he's starting to blaze the trail for self-publishers and really showing people the ethical way of self-publishing their books. He also has got a good friend, a mutual friend of mine, Sue Singh, and Sue Singh's just starting to break into her own YouTube channel. So I just wanted to use these two people just as an example of how the information content providers are starting to roll out. I mean, heck, there's even another one, Walter Wyburn. Walter's been in this business for nearly a decade, And I believe that this is going to be the year that those three and tons of others, maybe I have not even seen yet, are going to start to step it up, come to the forefront, and bring a lot more awareness to the self-publishing space. And this is good. This is great for everybody involved, because when people can kind of understand, they don't need this high barrier of entry of going into a traditional publishing deal. They're going to be like, oh gosh, I can make more money and I can do it all myself. Sign me up. This is great. Everybody wins in the long run. Number two, here we go. I'm going to say this one. It's a very bold claim, and it might be a little bit vague, but I think it's worth thinking about, and that's going to be brands cast a shadow. And when I mean brands cast a shadow, that means that no longer are we going to see these one-and-done authors, the ones that just like they just fire off underneath one pen name, and they fire off underneath this pen name, and they just do one just to try to chase a trend and be done with it. Brands are going to be the ones that succeed. And when I mean brands, that means the authors that have literally staked their claim. They've taken their flag and they've put it into the dirt and they said, this is my niche. And this is where I'm going to be prolific and super accessible. That's going to be the thing, is in order to be really a brand, is you need to have lots of content, many portions, many windows into what your brand is. And those windows could be everything from your books, like print books, ebooks, audiobooks, and it can even be videos. And I'm going to say this, videos for the win. It's been a long time in the making that many of these experts and pundits have said within the video content creation community that over 80% of online traffic is going to be derived from video content consumption going into 2020 and 2021. 80%, you think about that. And if you're just sitting here, just putting out, you just print publications and ebooks and audiobooks, you're greatly shackling yourself and limiting the exposure that you can have unless you otherwise have videos. So the authors that really think about being a brand that's going to be accessible, prolific, and quite frankly, you know, different from everybody else, the ones that are just shooting off, shotgunning and spraying and praying, those are going to be the ones that are going to win. And then there's going to be some people that are new. And I'm not trying to discourage you if you're new to the business. I'm not trying to tell you you shouldn't do it. But I'm going to tell you it's going to be the people that focus on the long-term plans, about the long game, that are going to really win. And those brands are going to cast a shadow. And it's going to be really tough to really be heard in the space unless you are an author brand. Number three, the levy breaks. Oh my goodness. Yep, this is one. This is bold. You've been following me long enough. You know I had a podcast previously, it's easy for me to say, that was called The Death of No Content Book Publishing. I foresee that the levy's going to break, because there's just so much content being flooded in. And I'm going to say specifically on Amazon KDP, there are some people that are just cramming 10 pounds of horse manure into a 5-pound bag. And some of them are doing good. And others are just taking these little small victories of selling one publication here and one publication there. Problem is, this is taking up server space over on Amazon. And yes, Amazon's got the largest cloud, you know, access in the world. Like, it's huge. Everybody uses Amazon. And Amazon Web Services, to be exact, AWS. You know, so eventually it's going to get to the point that they're going to go, okay, this isn't YouTube. You can't just go and fire off a bunch of stuff that's not going to be bringing in any kind of income. I foresee that eventually KDP is going to sniff this out. They're going to sniff it out and go, what's going on with this? Like, this person has 3,000 publications up here and only two of them are starting to draw any kind of money. They're taking up all this kind of server space and they're not bringing us any kind of revenue. So something's going to happen. Now, there's some things I've speculated before. I'll go ahead and repeat them, all right? I speculate that, one, they're going to start charging ISBNs on these people. They're going to say, hey, look, if you want this, you're going to have to pay for your ISBN. Okay, because at least when they pay for the ISBN, that's less money out of Amazon's pocket. And that also increases the barrier of entry. Now, the other one, a speculation I'm going to go ahead and give is, if it doesn't sell anything, they're going to do like what they do over in Merch by Amazon. And that's going to be purge content that is not selling anything. So if for some reason a book, a no content book particularly, doesn't sell really well, it's going to get purged. Bye-bye. See ya. It's gone. They're going to get rid of it. They're going to go, nope, it's not on here. And then Next one, and I would love to think, and if Amazon's paying attention to this, and I would, hey, what's going on, Amazon? How you doing? Why don't you call me anymore? I want to say something, you know, to Amazon and to you, and to think about this is, why don't they just do a completely different publishing service and get it to where that it's not just no content books being put in with the other pack of nonfiction and fiction books. It's not really fair to those books. And also, it's not fair to the people that are doing no content books because technically, they're not published books. They're stationary is what they are. And so I would love to see that Amazon starts to separate this out and make it completely separate. It could be like, say, for instance, no content, you know, publishing by Amazon. I don't know. Could be something like that. Because Amazon, let's admit it, there's no content book publishers that are bringing in hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars per month. So you don't want to shoot yourself in the foot. What I would say is separate those out and allow them to have browse paths that aren't normally available to fiction and nonfiction books. Because here's the thing is, you've got these no content book publishers that are putting themselves into fiction and nonfiction categories when they should probably be going into things like stationery and office supplies and things like that. So let's make things easy. Separate those out, put it into another different type of account, and that way people can go and have their cake and eat it too. So that's where I'm going to stand on that. The levy will break because there's millions that are pouring in per month. I know some of these self-publishers that are doing 1,000 per week, which is absolute insanity. If you're making money off those 1,000, kudos to you. But I think the vast majority of people are just forcing 1,000 publications onto the market. They're not so successful. All right. Number four, competition breeds innovation. I love this quote. My brother actually used it over when it comes to other platforms, but I'm going to go ahead and say that within self-publishing, competition breeds innovation. This year, they quietly rolled it out. Ingram Spark now has free ISBNs for US only, but they have free ISBNs. For the longest time, you had to go to Ingram Spark with your own ISBN and pay for the upload fees. Now, here's the big, you know, here's a really, really good tip, by the way. If you want to waive those upload fees, all right, visit DaleLinks.com/ally and get yourself signed up as an ally member, and you actually get all those fees waived. They have other benefits and things like that too. Now, if you're in the US, you can get an ISBN for free. They didn't say nothing. There was no email sent out. It just all of a sudden just popped up on their page one day. You can do ISBNs on your book for free. Listen, the police are starting to get it. They get it. Sound the alarm on this one. This is freaking awesome, man, because ISBNs are not cheap by any stretch. Here's the other one. Competition breeds innovation. Findaway Voices. Oh my gosh. They started out at the year, barely a couple dozen different avenues. Now they're at 41 different avenues for distribution of your audiobooks. I am going to continue to toot the horn of Findaway Voices and say, these guys are the bee's knees. And it's for good reason, because I spoke with Will Degas in person. And they plan to aggressively expand into the audiobook market. So that way you, the self-publisher, can reach many other different avenues. Now, it's still too soon for me to say to you that, man, I'm profiting hand and fist. But I'm going to say this, that I'm making money on publications that weren't necessarily making any money over an ACX. Think about that. Now, with that competition of Findaway Voices, though they're using Audible and Amazon and Apple, the avenues you get through ACX, I'm starting to believe that maybe ACX is going to sit up at attention and start to go, Findaway Voices is doing something interesting here. Should we be doing it too? A little sip here for myself here. I got to wet my whistle. So, at any rate, that's how I do this podcast. Pimples and all, we just go ahead and we just roll right with it. The other one to think about here, folks, is Drafted Digital. Drafted Digital has actually been in print beta for the better part of about a year, probably going close to 2 years. I'm going to point to the fences and draft. I have no insiders telling me this, by the way. Drafted Digital will probably start to fine-tune their print beta and hopefully launch it in 2020. With that being said, that means there's another print avenue for us to take advantage of. And this will hopefully get it to where the likes of Ingram Spark and KDP will sit up at attention and understand that we have multiple options. And this is so freaking cool. So why am I so excited? Competition breeds innovation. That means you, the self-publisher, have more options to choose from instead of just one or the other, or buying a pallet full of books to put inside your garage that turns into a coat rack or somewhere you put your tools on, and that's not a good thing. So I kind of love the fact that there's these self-publishing models that are stepping to the forefront. Hey, I just want to get a really quick plug here that every Monday, 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I'm actually recording these podcasts on twitch.tv/self-publish. You want to join me the week in advance of hearing this episode? All you got to do is go over to twitch.tv/self-publish. You can hit the follow and then turn notifications on so you don't miss a single one of these broadcasts. And also join me every Saturday at 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That is over on YouTube. And actually on YouTube, if you just do the quick link of dalelinks.com/live, you can join me every Saturday where we have some fun and exciting things. I'm going to tell you folks, 2020 is starting to come around the corner, and I'm going to say this, there's a lot of really cool things I'm going to be rolling out onto YouTube, a lot of more fun stuff. So, all righty, final prediction. Final prediction here, number 5. It's going to be the year of the audiobook, right? Some people might say, oh, but this year was the audiobook, or last year was the audiobook. No, you don't understand. I believe next year is going to be the year of the audiobook. So much so that all the self-publishers are starting to transition and understand that the investment is worth it, whether they invest in a great narrator or voiceover talent, or they invest in the equipment and do it themselves, because technology is becoming better, easier, cheaper, more accessible. So that means that more people are going to be making their own books as audiobooks and start to spread out into that. And those of you that are starting to break ground right now, you're smart for doing it, because going into 2020, I truly believe that audiobook is going to surpass all records before that. I'm not going to say it's as bold that audiobook's going to surpass all sales of ebook or print books, but I do see that in due time, that audiobook is going to be the thing that's going to be consumed the most. You got to pay attention to the fact, and let me go ahead and bring back to your memory here, that back in August, Audible rolled out an automated transcription service, and it wasn't a service per se. What they did was they transcribed people's audiobooks without their permission, which wasn't cool. Thanks a lot, Audible. And what they did was they were going to roll this out in September, and people could read as along with listening to the audiobook. When they're doing things like this, this is a large company that has been thinking about this, and I'm sure they spent tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars in making this technology, and it's probably for good reason. Why is that? Because they see the market's going to try to start to transition and pivot from consuming strictly ebooks and print books over to audiobooks. So the year of the audiobook is right around the corner. Are you equipped for it? I hope that you are. So, all right. Hey, I want to give just a big thank you again for listening. And this is episode 35. So it's kind of crazy that we got this far. Do me a favor. You're listening to this. Subscribe or follow me on your preferred podcast platform and leave me a review. Believe it or not, I do check those reviews. I keep saying this week after week, I was going to pull up a couple of reviews. Need to do that and give a big shout out to those that have given me a review. I appreciate it. All the 4 stars to the 5 stars and even the 1 stars in between. I do appreciate you taking the time out of your day to leave a review on your preferred platform. In the meantime, I want to know, what are your predictions about self-publishing in 2020? Do me a huge favor. You can always just drop me your thoughts at selfpublishingwithdale.com and just give me a little bit of a what's up, how you doing? It's always good to hear from you. Till later, this has been Self-Publishing with Dale, and I will talk to you next week.